Good evening, everyone. I am Dr. Swati Gogineni. I am a consultant obstetrician and gynecologist at the Apollo Cradle Jubilee Hills and Apollo Clinic in OU Colony, Manikota. So I am here today to discuss about vaccination in the preconceptional period and during pregnancy. So preconceptional period is actually a very important period. It is a period when a couple is actually going to plan for a pregnancy. So it is mandatory that they come and visit an obstetrician so that we give them good advice. So there are several issues that need to be addressed in the preconceptional period. First and foremost, we look into their lifestyle. So some of them might be very obese. So we advise weight reduction. Because of weight itself, there might be some issues. They might have difficulty in conceiving, or they might have some issues during pregnancy also. Similarly, certain habits like, you know, if she's used to smoking or alcoholism, they need to be addressed and stopped. And any other systemic issues, like she might be a known hypertensive or she might be a diabetic. So such issues have to be addressed. So basically those medical conditions need to be under control, because if they are not controlled, some of them might actually worsen during pregnancy. And even the pregnancy outcome might not be good. There might be complications during pregnancy, both maternal and fetal. So we have to make sure that those systemic conditions are under control. And another important thing is she might be on certain medications for those systemic conditions which are not actually safe in pregnancy. So if there is any such medication, that needs to be changed before itself. Similarly, the dosage of the medication also needs to be adjusted. So sometimes she might be on very high dosage and the condition might be actually under control. So we can reduce the dosage. Sometimes if the condition is not under control and the dosage needs to be increased, we can send her to the concerned doctor and make sure that the correct dosage is adjusted. And another important aspect is we have to start folic acid preconceptionally itself. So ideally it must be in the bloodstream from 2 to 3 months before conception itself. So when they actually start planning, we can ask them to start taking one tablet of folic acid, 5 milligrams every day. It is mainly given to prevent the spinal cord defects and the brain defects. So medically we say neural tube defects. So that is very important. We actually continue it even in the first trimester, that is up to 12 weeks. And apart from all this, pertaining to today's topic, talking about vaccination is also very important in the preconceptional period. So mainly I would like to highlight two things here. First thing is about rubella and varicella. So rubella and varicella, that means chickenpox, are basically two infections which are actually harmful during pregnancy. And as we all know, the immune system is actually, the immunity is lower during pregnancy, because of which a pregnant woman is more at risk of acquiring certain infections. So similarly, she is more at risk for acquiring this rubella infection and chickenpox infection. But unfortunately, if she acquires these during pregnancy, especially during certain critical periods, they can actually harm the baby. So they can cause some congenital malformations, and we might even have to advise termination also. But good thing is we have simple blood tests available in the market where we can actually check whether she is immune to them or not. So it is called rubella IgG and varicella IgG. So they are simple blood tests where we check for the immunoglobulins, and that to the IgG type, which actually tell us whether she is immune to them or not. So if IgM is positive, that means she is actually having the acute infection now. But if IgG is positive, that means she has had an infection in the past, or she must have received the vaccine also. And because of that, the IgG levels will be positive, but it means that she is immune. So once she is immune, she will not get the infection again during pregnancy. So that is a good thing. So we can actually advise her to do these blood tests. We can ask if she has had a history of chickenpox in childhood. If she has had, mostly it gives a lifelong immunity. But then if still we want to know the antibody titers, we can get these IgG levels done. And when we counsel her, we tell her that if the blood test is positive, it's actually a good thing, because she is immune to them, either because she must have received the rubella vaccine during childhood, or she must have had an infection, chickenpox infection during childhood, or she must have received the vaccination itself any time before. But if IgG is positive, she will be immune to it and she might not get it again during pregnancy. But what if the blood test is negative? If it is negative, it means that she is not immune to rubella and chickenpox. So she might get it during pregnancy because her immune system is compromised. But good thing is we have vaccination available in the market, and we can actually advise her to take this vaccine. So plain rubella vaccine is available, or sometimes we give a combination like measles, mumps and rubella called the MMR vaccine. Similarly for chickenpox, we have a direct chickenpox vaccine that is available. So we can advise her to take these vaccines. But one important point about these vaccines is they are live vaccines. So when we are administering the vaccine, we have to make sure that she is not pregnant. Because if she is pregnant, as I told you, when we give a live vaccine during pregnancy, what happens is, because first of all, the immune system is actually hampered a little bit. The virus tries to proliferate faster. It might cause, you know, an infection which actually mimics the actual infection. And that again can cross the placenta. It might affect the baby also. So we don't really give live vaccines during pregnancy. So we have to make sure she is not pregnant. So for that, usually we administer these vaccines in the first half of her menstrual cycle, usually before 10th day, so that, you know, we are sure that she has not ovulated and we are not going to harm a pregnancy. Similarly, if she has had a recent abortion, so immediately after the miscarriage, so post-abortal also, we can give the vaccine. Similarly, if she has delivered recently, she is lactating, she has not got her period, so immediately after delivery, we are sure that she is not pregnant again. So that is the period during which we give these vaccines. And another important advice is, after taking this rubella and chickenpox vaccine, we advise her not to get pregnant for at least 1 month. The reason being the same, so that, you know, the live virus doesn't proliferate and harm the pregnancy. But supposing there are any accidental pregnancies, we do keep coming across accidental pregnancies. In spite of counseling patients, they conceive in that immediate 1 month after receiving the vaccine. But still, that doesn't really warrant termination, because no serious adverse effects have been reported. But because it is a live virus, it can proliferate and cause that mild infection, which may harm the baby. We advise her not to get pregnant for 28 days. But again, they sometimes come back to us with a positive pregnancy report, like immediately after taking the vaccine. But we should not advise termination in such cases. And another important vaccination in the preconceptional period is the cervical cancer vaccine, that is a Gardasil or Cervarix. It is mainly given for the human papilloma virus. So most of you might have heard, this HPV is the main causative agent of cervical cancer. So what happens is, we can advise this, basically there are three doses of this vaccine. So if they take the zero dose, the next dose, that is the first dose, for example, the next dose is taken 2 months after this. And the third dose has to be given 4 months after the second dose. So by the time she receives all the three doses, it is about 6 months. Now, safety of this vaccine again during pregnancy is not really known. It is doubted. So better we not give it during pregnancy. So we can actually make use of the preconceptional period. If they can wait for 6 months before they plan pregnancy, they can take it. Or else they can finish their pregnancy and then after delivery, we can administer this vaccine. But again, tell her not to get pregnant in that 6 months period, because the safety issues basically are not fully known. But again, we do come across pregnancies where women accidentally conceive in that 6 months period. But again, that doesn't really warrant termination, so she can go ahead with the pregnancy. Now, coming to the second part, that is vaccination during pregnancy. So the main points I want to talk about is, see, the immune system, as I told, is actually lowered in pregnancy. That is a normal physiology of pregnancy, because of which, you know, it makes the pregnant woman more prone for any infection, like any other viral infection or bacterial infection. Of course, we have vaccinations available for some, so we can administer the vaccines. But the main points are, live vaccines should not be administered during pregnancy. So because the live virus, once it enters her bloodstream, either in the injection form or some vaccines in the nasal form, they actually proliferate and they can actually cause the actual viral illness, though in a less severe form. And because her immunity is lowered, in these women it might be a little bit more severe. And then it can actually cross the placenta and, you know, it might even affect the baby. So live viruses, live vaccines especially, should not be given during pregnancy. That is a dictum. Now, coming to the routine vaccinations in pregnancy, first and foremost, I would like to talk about the tetanus. So tetanus is a deadly infection, and we have the tetanus toxoid vaccine, the age-old vaccine. So here the first dose again. So normally we give between 16 to 20 weeks in our setup. But in India, in the rural setup, basically, you know, in the PHC, primary health centers, where we are not sure if the woman would come back to us for follow-up, they might be lost for follow-up. So in the first visit itself or second visit itself, very early in pregnancy, they give the first dose of tetanus toxoid. It is safe at any point of gestation. So always better to give it when we are not sure whether the woman would come back to us for follow-up or not. So previously, we used to give two doses of tetanus toxoid. So again, in our setup, the first dose around 16 to 20 weeks. And second dose, usually at least maintain 4 to 6 weeks gap between the two doses. And ideally, you give the second dose 4 to 6 weeks before delivery. So that is because the main aim is we want to even protect the baby against neonatal tetanus. So when we give it 4 to 6 weeks before delivery, the antibody formation and the placental transfer of antibodies and the neonatal protection has been shown to be maximum. But again, in the rural setup, for other reasons, as I told you, because giving it is more important because we are not sure if she might come to us again or not, they are giving the first dose very early, like around the first visit or second visit, and finishing off the second dose also 4 to 6 weeks later. But in our setup here, as I told, we used to give the we still give the first dose between 16 to 20 weeks. And second dose of plain TT, we used to give for like 4 to 6 weeks later. But again, the recent guidelines, instead of giving the second dose as plain TT, we are giving something called the Boostrix or the Tdap. It is basically a combination of tetanus, diphtheria, and pertussis. So what the Indian pediatricians have found out is, there is an increase in the incidence of pertussis and diphtheria. So they are again deadly infections. But unfortunately, what happens is, in the newborn I'm talking about. So basically, we vaccinate a baby against this diphtheria, pertussis, and tetanus only from 6 weeks onwards. So we give the first dose at 6 weeks, then 10 weeks, then 14 weeks. So in the first 6 weeks of their life, they are actually protected by the antibodies from the mother. So if we give only the tetanus toxoid, we are covering only tetanus, but we are not actually giving the baby protection against diphtheria and pertussis. And they can also be deadly infections. So for that reason, the pediatricians are actually recommending a combination. So we give a combination of all three, the diphtheria, pertussis, and tetanus. It's called Tdap or Boostrix. So a single dose is recommended. We actually give it as the second dose of TT. And it is recommended between 27 weeks to 36 weeks. That is again because they have chosen that period because the maternal antibody formation and transfer and the protection of baby in the first 6 weeks of life is found to be maximum if we give the vaccine at that period. One disadvantage in this setup is it is costly. TT is actually very cheap. So compared to TT, Tdap or Boostrix is costly, but we are actually counseling patients. So many people are agreeing that is a good thing. So you talk to them about the advantages of giving Tdap, though it is costly. And always better to give this combination vaccine as a second dose rather than just giving a plain TT. So this is actually the most important vaccine. Apart from this, the second is, of course, the flu vaccine. So flu is something, as all of you know, it's caused by the influenza virus. And again, main reason being the lowered immunity in pregnancy, flu can be more severe in pregnant women. So we can actually vaccinate them with this flu vaccine. So flu vaccine also has been shown to be safe at any period of gestation. But we can give it early also, but usually we prefer giving it in the second half of pregnancy. So it's again a single dose of flu vaccine. So we again have the live nasal vaccine here, which is not supposed to be given during pregnancy. So we give the inactivated form. So we give it in the injection form only. So especially in the flu season, like all of you know, the winter, basically October, November, December, January months. Now they are the months when actually flu is more prevalent. So when we administer this vaccine closer to that period in her pregnancy, the antibodies and, you know, protection of her and then the baby would be more. So usually we prefer giving it in the second half of pregnancy, but again, any vaccine, like, better to give it after the first trimester, but again, no major adverse effects have been really found out with the safe vaccines I'm talking about, even in the first trimester also. Now, apart from this, so as I told you, the live vaccines should not be given in pregnancy. So I want to name some of the live vaccines. So as I have told you, the measles vaccine, the mumps and the rubella, the MMR vaccine, similarly, the varicella zoster or the chickenpox vaccine should not be given during pregnancy. And the BCG is again another common vaccine which we give for tuberculosis. So BCG also must not be given during pregnancy. And the oral polio vaccine, it is a live vaccine which must not be given during pregnancy. And similarly, the oral typhoid vaccine and the active live vaccine in this influenza also, which is available sometimes as a nasal vaccine, must not be given during pregnancy. And there are other things which are safe during pregnancy. So the basic thing is the killed vaccines, inactivated vaccines, and sometimes, you know, the toxoids like the tetanus toxoids or the acellular vaccines, we say, like the pertussis vaccine, they are all safe during pregnancy. So for that reason, the combination DPT vaccine is very safe in pregnancy. And hepatitis B is another thing. It is actually a subunit vaccine. So it is again safe during pregnancy. But routinely, we don't give it. It has to be given only in a selected group of people. Like if the pregnant woman is having multiple sexual partners now, and if her partner is found to be hepatitis B positive and she is still having a relationship with him, an active relationship now, she needs to be given this hepatitis B vaccine. And it is a subunit vaccine, so safety-wise, it is safe during pregnancy. And similarly, certain travelers especially, if a pregnant woman is traveling to an endemic area, that is, you know, endemic for hepatitis A or, you know, endemic for meningococcal infection or endemic for yellow fever, like the African countries. So if there is going to be a history of travel, we can administer those vaccines. Otherwise, not routinely given, because those diseases are actually not endemic in India. So those vaccines can be given, but only on a selected basis. Similarly, rabies vaccine. So if she has had a dog bite history, yes, we can administer. We don't have to delay treatment because it is a deadly disease and the vaccine is safe in pregnancy. So we can give that vaccine during pregnancy. So to conclude, basically in the preconceptional period, so talk to her in the preconceptional period, look into her overall lifestyle, address all her systemic issues, then start her on folic acid and get the IgG tests for rubella and varicella. If they are positive, she can go ahead and plan pregnancy. If not, you can give her the vaccine. And while giving, make sure she's not pregnant. And ask her not to get pregnant for at least 1 month after she takes the vaccine. And HPV, you can give them a choice because they need to take all the 3 doses for a complete effect. And it takes 6 months. If they can wait, you can give it to her in the preconceptional period. Or else, after she finishes her pregnancy, after she delivers, she can take the vaccine. And during pregnancy, the routine vaccinations are tetanus toxoid. So according to the current guidelines, first dose between 16 to 20 weeks. And the second dose, we are giving Tdap or Boostrix between 27 to 36 weeks. And the flu vaccine also can be given in the second half of pregnancy. And the other vaccines, I want to name again, like the hepatitis A or yellow fever vaccine and meningococcal vaccine or hepatitis B or the rabies vaccine should be given only in selected groups, not routinely given. But live vaccines like the MMR vaccine, the varicella zoster vaccine and oral polio, oral typhoid vaccine or the live influenza virus vaccine must not be given during pregnancy. And just a last point about vaccination in the postpartum, that is breastfeeding mothers. So basically, studies have shown that all the vaccines are actually found in very negligible amounts in the breast milk. They are not really found in significant amounts in the breast milk. And they have not shown to cause any adverse effects on the baby. So any vaccination can be taken in the postpartum period while breastfeeding. And or you could wait a little longer, but there are no major side effects while giving vaccination in the postpartum period for breastfeeding mothers. Thank you. So I see a question here about safety of human papillomavirus vaccine in pregnancy. So as I told, the safety of human papillomavirus in pregnancy is not fully known. So we don't have many studies on that. And the vaccine data suggests that better avoid giving this vaccine during pregnancy. So for that reason, as I told you, finish it off in the 6 months before planning pregnancy. Or if they cannot wait for 6 months, let her finish her pregnancy. And after she delivers, you can give it in the postpartum period. So actually, when a woman comes to us in the postpartum period, we inquire about whether she has taken this HPV or not. Because this drive against cervical cancer prevention is actually very, very important in India because there is an increase in the incidence of cervical cancer. So we talk to all women after they deliver about this vaccine. If they have taken it, it's fine. But if they have not taken it, we encourage her to take those 3 doses as soon as possible. But better to avoid this vaccine in pregnancy. Anything else? Yeah, so I see another question. Does a gynecologist give a list of vaccines that a pregnant woman needs to take? Yes, definitely. So we are actually encouraging, you know, you to come in the preconceptional period. We'll talk to you about the vaccines that need to be taken in the preconceptional period. And similarly, even during pregnancy also. So when a woman comes to us, you know, with a positive pregnancy test, apart from talking about the routine medications and the scans, we talk to them about the vaccinations also. We tell them when the TT injections have to be taken, why the Tdap or Boostrix needs to be taken. And we also give them a choice about the flu vaccine. And the other vaccines, as I told you, yes, we do mention about them, especially a woman who is a frequent traveler. She's going to endemic areas or anything like that. She needs to take those vaccines. Otherwise, our routine vaccinations, we advise and we mention about them to every pregnant woman. Are live vaccines safe in pregnancy? As I told you, no, they are not safe, should not be given. Because the virus might proliferate and actually cause the infection during pregnancy. So don't give live vaccines in pregnancy. And what is the role of flu vaccine in pregnancy? Flu is mainly the common flu, so cold, cough, fever, and in pregnancy, because of lowered immunity, it might actually, you know, present in a severe form. The infection might even go to the lungs and might even cause systemic issues. So for that reason, flu vaccine needs to be given in pregnancy. And as I told you, ideally it can be given at any point of time. Like for example, she's only in her early pregnancy, but the flu season is going to start, we can administer the vaccine even during early pregnancy. But ideally speaking, in the second half of pregnancy, as I told you, closer to that October, November, December, Jan, that is when we see more number of flu cases. So a single shot of flu vaccine can be given. And the vaccine can be administered during breastfeeding. I had already told about this. None of the vaccines have been found to be, you know, to be found in significant amounts in the breast milk, and they have not shown to cause any major side effects also in the baby. So yes, they can be given during breastfeeding. And timing of tetanus toxoid in pregnancy, as I told you, yes, in the current, in our setup, the first dose between 16 to 20 weeks. So usually we combine it with the TFA scan, which is done between 18 to 22 weeks. And the second dose, we are giving Tdap or Boostrix, and we give it between 27 to 36 weeks. But where we are anticipating a preterm delivery or anything, you can give it a little early, like 27, 28 weeks. But otherwise, usually around 32, 33 weeks, so that we are actually, we want the antibody levels to be good, and we want the newborn to be protected in the first 6 weeks of life. What are the other vaccines safely given during pregnancy? So basically, I want to summarize the tetanus toxoid, the combination diphtheria, pertussis and tetanus, then the inactivated flu vaccine, and the hepatitis B vaccine, the rabies vaccine, and the hepatitis A vaccine, sometimes a yellow fever vaccine, meningococcal vaccine needs to be given. But not to be given list is more important. So don't take the MMR vaccine, chickenpox vaccine, BCG for tuberculosis, and the oral polio vaccine, the oral typhoid vaccine, or the live active nasal influenza virus vaccine should not be taken during pregnancy. So I think any more questions? So thank you everyone. So I'm available for physical consultation at Apollo Cradle in Jubilee Hills from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. in the mornings. And I'm available at Apollo Clinic in OU Colony, Manikonda from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. every day, Monday to Saturday. So you can come and visit me in case you have any queries. Thank you.